my pleasure to introduce Terry Wilson to you for the program today. He's a chief executive officer of the St. Elizabeth Health System here in Lafayette. He was here the last time when they were getting ready to build the hospital over on the east side and told us all about that. Now they've got another addition in the prospects, and I think that's what he's planning to talk about mainly today. But please welcome Terry Wilson.
Chuck, thank you very much, and thank you to the group for having me. I want to take care of a couple of administrative items before I start talking about all the fun we're having at Franciscan St. Elizabeth. First, if I get out of here without thanking you for your generosity in recent years, our foundation people will send me back to try harder. Your group has been very generous to us. Recently in 2013, when we were launching our Franciscan Healthy Living Center, which is an effort to help coordinate care outside the hospital, something that's very important nowadays. And the second time in 2015, when we were trying to help new families who had babies in our neonatal intensive care unit, and perhaps didn't have the resources that some have, and we provide them with pack and plays, the sort of portable playpens that are so handy nowadays. And we are grateful for that support. I want to also add my thanks to the veterans in the room on Memorial Day weekend. I wrote about this recently in our I do a blog for all the people who work at St. Elizabeth's. And there's always been a special connection between healthcare and the military. And I lived with a fabulous example of that, because in about 1942-43, the United States Navy sent my father to medical school. And the rest, as they say, is history. He got invited back. He did so well the first time, they invited him back during the Korean conflict when he could actually be productive, and he was doing more than studying. And so he got to go back to try harder a second time. I want to also add that many years ago, I had the privilege of coaching Little League in West Lafayette, and this young man right here, Musashi Fukada, was on one of those teams, and he was a joy to be around, as were his mom and dad, who helped a great deal. So, Musashi, congratulations. It's been a while, but congratulations, buddy. So, when this happens at St. Elizabeth's and somebody calls and says, can Terry Wilson come and speak in front of a group? And our marketing and communications people, led by Lisa Decker, who many people in this room probably know because she knows everybody in this community, says, yeah, I think that'll be a good idea. Why don't you do that? And I'll say, well, what do you want me to talk about? And they said, well, they'd like you to talk about the future of healthcare and some of the things that we're investing in this community. And I say, but how about if I could go and talk about the fact that my alma mater, Villanova University, won the NCAA men's basketball championship here? So I could, that's shameless, but I couldn't help doing that. You give me a microphone and I'm going to talk about that. And they said, no, how about if you talk about the future of healthcare in this community? So I tried several other things, and they brought me around to talk about the future of healthcare in this community, and I'll talk a little bit about that and a little bit about some of the challenges that we all face in healthcare nowadays. And if I spend about 15 minutes doing that, and then we can answer questions, does that work for everybody? Okay. So before we start talking about the future, a little bit of history. This past December and then in January, the Sisters of St. Francis of Perpetual Adoration, the sisters who sponsor our health system, had two very important anniversaries. On December 14th, this past December 14th, that was the 140th anniversary of when our sisters came to this country and came to Lafayette. That their community was started in a little town in southern Germany called Olpe, Germany, and they, for a variety of reasons, in order to grow the order, sent six sisters to this community after an invitation by the then Catholic bishop for this part of Indiana, Bishop Joseph Dwenger from Fort Wayne. And six sisters got off a train in downtown Lafayette 140 years ago this past December. In 3 weeks, they had made arrangements to rent a house, and that house still stands at the corner of 10th and Cincinnati Streets downtown. It's an old, they've referred to it as a house, but it's an old sort of a block-looking building, and it's now been painted green, and it's still in use, I believe, as apartments. Someone rented it to them, and 3 weeks after they started, they accepted patients into that old house. And so they had a, so our health system had a 140th anniversary this past January. We're very proud of that. So what is that today? Today that is Franciscan Alliance. That is 14 hospital campuses in two states, two in Illinois, two hospitals in Illinois, and 12 hospitals in Indiana. We employ about 18,000 people in those two states. It stretches from the far south side of Chicago in Olympia Fields and Chicago Heights to our southernmost hospital campus in Mooresville, and all points in between. The piece of that that our team here is responsible for is what we call the Western Indiana Division of Franciscan Alliance, and we are responsible for four hospital campuses. The two here in town, St. Elizabeth East and St. Elizabeth Central, St. Elizabeth in Crawfordsville, and what we now call Franciscan Health Rensselaer in Rensselaer, Indiana, what before we bought it was known as Jasper County Hospital. And so our team here is responsible for those four campuses. So what are we investing in? As a way of telling you what we think the future looks like, what are we investing in? Well, we're very fortunate, and our corporate board of trustees in Mishawaka has been very generous to us. We have just begun what will total, when it's all finished, about $80 million worth of construction and renovation on three of those four hospital campuses. So let me walk through those. The East Campus, Chuck talked about the fact that the last time I was here was right before we built that hospital. We've been in that hospital, this is hard for me to believe, we have been in that hospital for 6 years and 3 months. And it is essentially full. Now that's a, when you do what I do for a living, that's a nice problem to have. And my colleagues, if I say, you know, we're full again, they'll tell me to take my problems elsewhere because they have other issues to deal with. But we're very fortunate. It has been very successful and very well received in the medical community and the community at large. So it's full. So here's what we're investing in on that campus. We have just replaced a MRI, a magnetic resonance imaging machine, and we're finishing that project. We're adding an operating room. So there'll be nine general operating rooms when we finish this project later this summer, and the 10th will be shelled in. The 10th will be a box that we could finish off and have active in about 90 days if we wanted it. We are expanding the waiting room in the surgical area. So if you've ever had to wait for a loved one who's having surgery in our facility and you've waited in that waiting room, my apologies. It was probably never big enough. But we are expanding that waiting room to make that part of people's experience a little better. And the big project, we started talking about publicly a couple of months ago, and you probably saw in the paper or on the news, is an additional inpatient building on that campus. That is the picture that you see to the left up front here. And the picture closest to you in that rendering, the building closest in that rendering is the new building, and it faces to the west, so if you go straight out from that white canopy, you're going right at Creasy Lane. Okay? It is a third building, almost identical to the two off to the sides of it, and it will add 55 beds, inpatient beds, to that campus. We will use most of them for general medicine and surgery, probably most of them for general medical kinds of conditions. In addition to that, the ground floor will add outpatient space to that campus, which is very much needed. And that building, we hope, will open early in 2018. And it will expand our capacity to, something just over 200 beds on that campus. That building, give you an idea of how expensive hospital space is, that building will cost approximately $57 million to build, and it will take 18 months to, better not take 2 years, because I will have missed a deadline by then if it does, but it'll certainly take about a year and a half. A lot of people ask me, okay, so what's going to happen to the central campus in the middle of town? And I can tell you a couple of things that will absolutely happen. I'll talk a little bit about some planning that we're doing down there. First of all, we have no plans to abandon that site. We think it's an important part of our healthcare ministry. It is absolutely an important part of our sister's history in this town and in this country. That was home for many, many years. The mother house for our sister's order was on that site until 1943. So from 1875 to 1943 when they moved it to Mishawaka. We think that's an important place for us to be. We've been a neighbor in that community for a long time, and we're going to invest back in it, along with others, we think, and hope, to really breathe some life back into that immediate neighborhood. So what's going to happen? Well, we have a school of nursing, have had for, 100 years or so, and that school of nursing is currently in the old school building on that campus. It was the beginning, the keystone on the building says St. Francis College. That was the start of what is now the University of St. Francis in Fort Wayne, our sister's college in this country. And our School of Nursing has been in that building for a long time. They need new space. Anybody that age going to school right now has a computer in their hands 90% of the time, and you can walk into some of those classrooms and there'll be two electrical plugs for people to plug a computer into, and there are many educators in the room, I know, and that just doesn't fly. So what we're going to do is we're going to renovate some of the newer hospital space on that campus and move the School of Nursing out of the old school building into the newer parts of the hospital building on that campus and provide them modern educational space. We're going to cluster in there our other educational space, so space that we need to do continuing education for our doctors and nurses and therapists and so forth. We've had a successful training program for paramedics and EMTs for many, many years. That program will be clustered in that new educational space. Last thing, our Catherine Weil Center for Patient Education is on that campus. It's in what we call the Bill Long Building over at the corner of Salem and 14th Street. That program will be clustered near that new educational space. So patients and families going through various education programs will get to use that new space as well. Our goal is to finish that project. That's about a $15 million project. And that project will start here yet this summer and finish. Our goal is to have any nursing students who start school in the fall of 2017 will begin in that new space. So fall of 2017, so 15 months or so from now. So then that begs the question, what about the rest of that campus? Well, we have lots of things on that campus, some of which are going to stay there. Some will move into that new building on the east campus, but some things will stay there. We have planning to do to decide what we're going to do with our behavioral health space. We have both outpatient behavioral health and inpatient psychiatry on that campus, and we have to plan for the future of those two pieces of the program. There are some very old buildings there. The West Wing, which is not the original building on that site, but very close, was built in 1885. And there are buildings connected to it that are almost as old. The chapel stays. I can finish this speech, and if I never raise a chapel, somebody will raise their hand and say, what's going to happen to that chapel? The chapel's not going anywhere. But some of the older buildings, we have to make a decision about. We get a variety of calls all the time from people who like to renovate and reuse and redevelop old buildings, and we're in discussion with some of those folks locally, some folks from out of town who have plans for down there. So more to come on that campus, but we are going to make a substantial investment in our education space going forward. Third, the hospital in Crawfordsville. That emergency room in Crawfordsville is one of the most productive little spaces. I've been doing this for 30 years, and it's one of the most productive little spaces I've ever seen in terms of the number of patients they can treat in that emergency room. It's probably, that space probably is about as